Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Big Jack Monthly Cup. And today the day has finally come because we're going to be playing, or rather spectating, the monthly final of the month of September. Players had 4 weeks to qualify for this monthly final, and now we have the 20 best players of the month left who will battle it out against each other today for prizes worth of €400 in a very interesting format. So since it's the monthly final, we're not going to be using the cup mode format that we usually use. Instead, we're going to be using a custom knockout mode. So we have 20 players, as I said, and it is going to be knockout, just as in cup of the day. But every single player will have 3 lives. So if they lose out, if they basically get last in one round, they're not immediately out. They have 3 lives. And in the ending, there will still only be one man standing. But it's going to be way more interesting because it is possible to do crazy comebacks with 1 life. It's possible to lose everything in 1 map. It's going to be really crazy. So the format, very simple to understand. We will also have some cool overlays, which should explain everything you need to know. Regarding the maps, this month's theme, of course, is about randomizing styles and then randomizing maps for each style. And in the weekly qualifiers, I always randomized 3 styles and 5 styles per map. This week, though, to make it a little bit less random, I instead randomized 15 styles and then 1 style per map. So we're going to have 15 different maps of different driving styles, and we're going to play every single one of them. The way it's going to work is that on each map that we're playing, players have 1 short warm-up, and then we're going to play 2 rounds on each map. So not 3, but 2 in the monthly final. And yeah, that's basically everything you need to know for now. Players already on the server, so I would say at John C, please start the tournament, and players can start to cook. I am ready. Players are hopefully as well. Good luck, have fun, and we're gonna jump to the very first map of today. It's gonna be interesting. Let's see what it is. I also tried to memorize all of the 15 styles and what map belongs to that style. So if my brain is not entirely stupid today, I should always be able to tell you the style of each map, but maybe also not. We will see. We're gonna start on map 1, which is called Punta Gorda. And this is actually a very proper map. I tested all of the maps, don't worry, so to make sure that we don't have any shit maps that are undrivable. And this map here is definitely, or it was supposed to be, a NASCAR map. So NASCAR, the driving style where you mostly drive on tarmac, fast turns, a lot of nose sliding usually. And yeah, this is going to be map 1, a pretty normal and solid map to start with. So I don't think this is a map anyone can complain about.
Oh, it's actually thick. It's water as well.
It's water.
No, this is a start.
No, and the end.
Oh, hell nah.
No?
Oh, the finish was
water drifts, fuck no.
And yeah, I would say we're going to jump into the first warm-up and we're going to see what players are going to do. First of all, we have water in the start. The thing is, it is actually fake water. So players need to figure that out. It's not real water. You basically just drive through it, but it doesn't have the water physics. And yeah, this is the map. In the meantime, I can present you the 20 players, yeah, who managed to qualify. We have Croxy, Elkon, Intax, Jan van Achtern, Blef, Arpa, Tarpor, Heath, Lars, August, Nice, Salmon, Marijntje, Snappy, Skandir, Fredwolf, Flo, Purple, and Padenfechter. Those are the top 20 players. They all either managed to qualify by points or by, yeah, doing really good in the weekly qualifiers. And yeah, we will see who is going to be the best one of the month. But a very cool map here. Should have some good races here for us. And now I got to explain you a little bit more about the knockout mode. Because, first of all, let me quickly disable this. And let me also disable this. We have this overlay here. And in this overlay, you can always see on what map we are, on what round we are, and how many people will lose a life. So the way it's going to work is that we have 15 maps, of course. On the first 5 maps, always the bottom 3 players of each round will lose a life. On the second 5 maps, so map 6 to map 10, always the bottom 2 players will lose a life. And then on the final 5 maps, always only the very last player will lose a life. You can always read that in the top left here. And that is basically how it's gonna work. Marius is in the corner. Yeah, hello, my name is Marius. And I always stay in voice chat, even though nobody is there. Fantastic. So let's see, round 1. Elkon currently in last place. And Elkon is, of course, one of the favorites, arguably. And I mean, especially in these easy rounds, it is not too hard to not lose a life. You basically only need to survive the rounds and not die. But look at this, Elkon on first red position and losing his very first life together with Flo and Padenfechter. Damn. That is not very good for Elkon. Of course, you're not out until you have no lives left. So even if he loses another life now in the next round, he could still win overall, but it will make it significantly more difficult. And let me tell you, later on, there's going to be some maps coming up where it's quite easy to, you know, do bad. Like, this is a very consistent map here, but not all of them are that easy and that simple. And yeah, so we will see. We will see. Anyway, next round, we have Flo falling a little behind. Flo also lost a life in the previous round already. So could be tricky for him. He doesn't want to lose another one, that's for sure. So let's see. Of course, we're going to always focus a little bit more on the back end of the field than usual. Front end, of course, also interesting. But it's more interesting to see who is going to lose a life in what round. And if we have some crazy fights. So let's see. Flo is looking definitely better in this round. Never mind, he's not. He might actually... Oh my god, we have such a close fight! Whoa, holy shit, look at this. The entire field within 1.6 seconds. Look at that. And there were like four people within a tenth near the ending. Look at these times. That's crazy. Well, the two rounds already are over and we move on to the next map, which is called 5000 Follower Cup by Giuliano. So a map built by German streamer Giuliano. And yeah, this map is part of the category Moving Blocks. Because, you see, we have some moving blocks here. And this one definitely is a little bit more dank. This one is not easy at all. You have some crazy risky ways that you can go for. As you can see, a huge-ass Döner Spieß here that you can go over. Kind of reminds me of this one, the Mario Kart DS Bowser Castle. Then also here, you can go for some rally car ice slalom with moving blocks, but also can go through the slow-mos. And then you always have to drop one part down. It's a very, very dank map, not easy to do at all. And in the ending, we have a very long pipe, as you can see. Look at this. Crazy, crazy map. Definitely one of the hardest maps that we're going to see today. But I mean, it's of the category moving blocks. Moving block maps, as you can imagine, are rather dank. And I think I even rerolled this map multiple times. And this is the best I... this was the most drivable map out of like three or four... randomized rows. So yeah, gonna be interesting. And look at this, Fredwolf is saying he won this competition. He won the 5000 follower cup on this map, so he actually knows the map. That is interesting. Okay, everybody flipping around. Is anybody going for the risky? Yes, a few people are. For example, I tapped out. Yeah, hello. Fantastic. Professional streamer. Pardenfechter apparently made it. He is very far ahead, actually. Going for the safe here. But some people are still behind. Oh, people struggling with the moving blocks. And one of them is actually Fredwolf, who won the competition. He knows the map, but he is struggling. That is interesting. So here, into rally car. You see there is a big gap between players. We should have enough of a finish timeout, though. So it should be possible for everyone to finish, hopefully. Unless somebody fully trolls, of course. Then it's not going to be possible. Oh, and look at this. Croxy had to respawn. No, Croxy is fully in the mud. But look at this. We have 90 seconds of a finish timeout. Skandir finishing in first. Within 90 seconds, like 1.5 minutes, everybody should be able to finish. And if you don't manage to, you don't deserve. You don't deserve it. So let's see. Crazy map for sure. Flo is living on the edge here. He only has one life and he is on orange. Holy shit, eh. That means Arpa, Jan van Achten, and Croxy are all gonna lose a life here. But holy moly, what a map, eh? This is definitely a crazy map. But it's drivable, so I decided to choose it. Yeah. One round left on this one. Let's see what's gonna happen in this round. Will be interesting. We are going in with Elkon, maybe. Elkon, always a bit of a risky player. He lost one life early. Since then, he has been looking solid. Trying to go for a fast turnaround, not really working out, but honestly, you don't have to be fast here at all. As long as you survive, it's fine. I tried to find one of the risky players, but I couldn't find one. I saw Lars made it. So Lars going for the risk and surviving it. That is pretty juicy. Oh, Blef actually died with the moving obstacle against the wall. That is, yeah, not so great. That is very unfortunate. But yeah, yeah. Many people here still close to each other, actually. Nobody really full dead. I mean, yeah, but no, not really. Oh, and look at this. We have Pardenfechter currently... Oh, where's Nice going? Nice going for... Oh, nice headed dead respawn. Okay, nice, we'll lose a life. I think Padenfechter will as well. Snappy is here. Padenfechter, is he gonna survive or is he out? Oh, he's losing a life again. Oh my god, so we have now already three people who are down to one life. Padenfechter, nice, and also Flo, of course. Damn. Damn, 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 damn. Anyway, we're gonna go to the next map. And this map is called Circuit Nürburgring. We literally have a remake of the Nürburgring in the Big Egg Monthly Cup. And I'm pretty sure this one belongs to the style of Endurance. This is one of the Endurance maps. It was very hard to find an Endurance map, which is not like 10 minutes long, by the way. So this is, yeah, the best one I could come up with. So this is going to be very interesting. Nürburgring. Basically, in Trackmania terms, this will be tech, but awkward tech, if that makes sense. We're going to follow Lars for the warm-up, maybe. But it is going to be like really weird tech. But should be a skill map. I don't think people can complain too much about it. There's also definitely some Neo slides you have to do, for example, in this corner. So not a super easy map. And of course, also quite long, like 116 offer time. People, even though, even if they make a mistake near the beginning, they can still come back, which is the good thing about long maps. So we will see what is gonna happen here. Looking good so far from Lars. Most people actually surviving. I mean, the map is also like, you see quite easily where to go. Not hard to find that, but it's going to be hard to memorize everything and to actually get a good run through then. So we will see. Elkon dominating the warm-up here, actually. That is pretty crazy. It's quite far ahead of the others. But you see, many people are close to each other, and I think it's going to be the same in the live rounds. But we will see. Definitely interesting map. Something unique. Oh, big chicane here. Some people crashing, but most people surviving it. And I think this, yeah, this already is the final corner, and we have Elkon easily winning the warm-up. Look at that. The thing is, this time, I'm pretty sure everybody got the chance to see the entire map in the warm-up. So, it should be fine for everyone. I think we're going to have very close races here. So, who do we follow is the question. What about, what about Padenfechter? One of the players with only one life left. So, let's see. Gets a good start. Not doing a Neo slide actually, but saving it pretty nicely. Oh, small touch here. Not too bad of a touch, but he shouldn't replicate that. That's for sure. Ah, but look at this. Some players with low speed. Some others are rushing ahead. Elkon, one of them. Padenfechter. Yeah, in the middle of the field still. A little bit away from the others. So let's go back to the risky positions. Let's call them that way. Because we have constant fights. It's currently Marijn in last place. And Marijn, that looks kind of difficult for him. And he already only has two lives. So losing another one is nothing he wants. But look at this, two crashes, three touches, and Marijn overtaking three players in one turn. And if he survives now, it should be fine. So, Bleff. Bleff and Auris are fighting. Auris now on the risky spot. Oh, he touched Salmon. Can Salmon overtake one? I don't think it's enough. Croxy doesn't have that great speed, but it's going to be enough. And wait, Salmon made it. Wait, what? What happened? Huh? Wait, Heath? What happened to Heath? What happened to Heath? Okay, I don't know what happened to Heath, but something happened to him. Unlucky. I didn't really understand the ending. But anyway, we had three people with three lives losing a life there. Crazy. Crazy, crazy, crazy. In the meantime, Chevron Q, thank you very much for the 40-month resub. And we're gonna hop into round two on the Nürburgring. Let's see. Let's maybe follow the front end a little bit more this time. Who are the actual fast players here? Who are risking it even though they can save? Currently, it is Fredwolf who is cooking. But, I mean, if there is someone who is playing risky, it is definitely L to the con. Oh, what are those lines by Fredwolf? Definitely not the greatest lines. So far, we also don't have any knockouts, actually, which is interesting, even though we are on map 3 already. But this could change this time, because Padenfechter and Flo are in the danger zone. Padenfechter with good speed here. So let's see what he is gonna... Ooh, oh, good line, very risky. That touch could have cost him his life. Ah, but also Nace and Flo are in danger. Flo needs to catch one, but Flo is catching the wall instead, but he's still overtaking people. What is happening? I think Flo is gonna be safe. But Auris overtaking. Auris also had only two lives. I'm so confused. But... And we have the first knockout. It is actually nice getting into 20th position here. Nice, the first one being knocked out. GG to him. Well played nonetheless. There was a close fight between Nice and... who was it? Auris? I didn't remember. But he had a very close fight with another person with only one life. So yeah, good race. But we have to say bye-bye. 07 to our first player. And we go over to the next map, which is called Fablol, built by Oxybuff. And this one, I'm not sure. But I'm pretty... No. The style of this map is mini. This is the mini map that I rolled. So this one, a little bit more dank, a little bit weird. But it should be fine, hopefully. It should be fine. So let's see. You cannot go beneath the dingsbums here. I guess people saw that. And in the ending, you can go for a wall ride if you want to. I tried that when I tested the map. I only tried it once because I didn't really, like, you know, hunt anything or so. I just tried if that's possible. And you can go for a wall slide. So it will be interesting if people are going to go for that. Especially when they are in the bottom three and they need to risk. So let's see. Yeah, this format is stolen. Fair, but... It's good, so why not? And there's no rights on Trackmania formats. All Gucci, guys. Oh, look at this. Lars with a weak start this time. And now the ending will be interesting. Will Lars go for the wall slide? Is he aware? No, he's not aware. But look at this. Auris did it, and Auris gained quite some time. But, holy moly, that was a quick round, of course. It's a mini-map, so obviously it doesn't take long. And we have to say bye-bye to Padenfester. Damn. Sarge, Padenfester, sadly knocked out in 19th position here. GG to Padenfester, GG to our Dutchie. Well played. So let's see, Jan van Achtern. Also only one life left, but getting a really good start here. Let's see, will he survive the slalom? Yes, it's not too hard to survive, to be fair. Then, of course, make sure to go inside here. I saw Fredwolf had to release a lot. Nein, I tapped out again, I joined the voice chat again. Ah! And it's Flo being out. RIP. We lose another one. 07 to Flo. And that's already it with the minimap. Very short one. But a good map. Next up, we have Fries in the Back by Frank the Hamster. And this is a map of the category Backwards. I rolled Backwards as one of the styles. And it's actually a Backwards bobsleigh map. If that's not crazy, then I don't know. So you can do Backwards speed sliding, of course. But then you need to carry that speed into freaking... Bobsleigh. We have a backwards bobsleigh map by Frank the Hamster. Frank also in the chat. So yeah, I rolled one of your maps. And holy moly. But you see, like, the thing is, like, you can gain speed in the dirt parts by speed sliding. But you cannot really gain speed in the bobsleigh. So you need to carry as much speed as possible into them. Otherwise, you will be fully in the mud. And you see the crazy speed difference. Like, Fredwolf got it good, and he's, like, multiple seconds ahead of everyone. We also have a risky finish. I don't know how hard it is, but as you can see, it is very hard. So, I'm not sure. Honestly, you should just go for clean lines, and you should not go for the risky finish. Like, the risky finish is legit difficult. This map was released yesterday. I also rolled the maps yesterday. I must have rolled it, like, right before, basically. And yeah, one really deadly thing is when you don't get the SD in the start, because you will miss out on so much speed throughout the entire map. And look at what happened to Mr. Elkon. Oh, Arpa. Arpa having to go for the respawn. Skandir with really low speed. And Elkon, look at this. Elkon with insane speed overtaking. Yeah, not everyone, but a lot of players. So Elkon should be safe here. Boah, look at this. The speed sliding by Elkon. He is coming back from... holy moly. Crazy. The thing is, we still have the ending. Are people gonna go for the risky? Marijn is going safe. You can overjump the safe finish, though. That's the risky. Elkon won the round. He went for the risky finish. What the fuck? He lost 2 seconds in the start. He won the round. Holy moly, eh. That is crazy. And we still have... Okay, people have finished by now. It is Intax, Tarpor, and Arpa losing a life here. But so far, we really don't have that many knockouts. Only 3. But I'm pretty sure... yeah. It's not that unlikely that we're gonna see a knockout this round. So let's see. Skandir, not with the greatest start, but it looks like he has good speed. Croxy wobbling around like an absolute crazy man. Jan van Achtern having a bump. That's like every single thing that is not smooth is losing you speed here. That is not good. Wait, and Blisky, what did Blisky do? Okay, Blisky is fully in the mud. Not sure what he did. Wait, Blisky went wrong way in the start? He steered the wrong direction? Ain't no way. Risky finish by Salmon, risky finish! Okay, if you have good speed, I guess it's fine. But it's very easy to not have good speed. And what is happening? People are not finishing. It is Bleff barely surviving. And with that, no, we have to say bye-bye to our German Jan van Achtern, 07. See you, Jan van Achtern. He will finish in 17th position. Unlucky, GG. And with that, we also have Croxy and Plisky going down to one life only. Actually, how many players are left with all three lives still? There should be a couple. Oh, very interesting map. This map is part of the category minigame. And minigame maps were also very hard. It was very hard to find a good minigame map. So, yeah, this one is somewhat drivable. We have a crazy speed check in the ending where you have to jump here and land in the hole. But I can tell you one thing. I don't think anybody of the players is listening. I can tell you one thing. There is a very easy 15-second shortcut on this map. And I am wondering if someone is going to find it. I'm not going to tell more. I can tell you once the map is over. But there is a huge shortcut you can do here. And if you are smart of a player and your brain is braining, then you will easily survive this map. No problem. I won't tell any of your players. Yeah, I'm not going to tell what exactly it is. That's what I meant. So you see Intax going for clean lines. Yeah, some people are smart. Maybe you saw it, guys. Maybe you saw what you can do.
If it's another ring CP, just double respawn and code GPS.
Yeah, look where the second... That's true.
Dude, I don't understand this map.
It is another ring. It is a ring CP. Double respawning.
Wait, is it working?
Wait. Yes. Oh my god, yes.
Maybe you shouldn't have done it in normal. Surviving. Okay.
We're surviving.
I wonder if you guys saw what it is. I'm just gonna show you this. Then no more checkpoint. Finish. Let's see.
Oh no. I got the slowdown. That is bad. Ooh, but other people failed as well. That slowdown is terrible because I probably also won't make this jump now. Do I? Oh, I do. I do make that jump. That's important. That is so important. Okay, now just normal roll ride and finish. Golf. Yeah. That's what I didn't see earlier. We're in. 20 seconds behind? They're cutting. How are they cutting? Wait, wings? It's just wings. There is the both checkpoints are rings, so we just respawn and we go into this finish. Okay, we're just standing respawn and go into that finish, I guess.
Heath needs to finish. Or is it Arpa? Wait, we still have a fight going on. Okay, Heath is gonna finish and Heath 44 seconds behind first and he's not losing a life. Because Intax DNF'd. And with that, we have to say bye bye to Arpa. Can we get an 07 for Arpa? That is unlucky. 16th place for him. GG nonetheless. But Arpa is out. Yes. OCN Echo. So for those of you who still didn't understand, the final check, like this is, we only have two checkpoints and both of them are rings. And when you standing respawn on a ring, you cannot standing respawn them. So you will standing respawn to the start instead, and then you can just drive to the GPS finish, basically. We have many people actually who made a mistake. Not sure what happened to them. Elkon is gonna win another round. Skandir doesn't even have checkpoint one yet. What happened to Skandir? Skandir is most likely gonna be out, but we have a fight. Plisky versus Auris, and I also don't know if everybody has the trick by now. We will see. Auris has it, Plisky has it as well. So probably... Wait, Skandir failed as well. I know, Skandir was behind all the way. Hello, they failed the standing respawn. Hello. No way Skandir survived. Nah, there is no way Auris and Heath both failed the standing respawn. Ain't no way. They both lost a life because they fucked up the final standing respawn. That is honestly funny. Next up, we have a map by Scorsor. We have SIT, like this ice campaign, gear management. We have ice tutorial map, ladies and gentlemen. And this map is part of the map style. The previous map was minigame. This map is part of the map style educational. It's an educational map. It's supposed to teach players about gears. You even have like explanations flying around here, as you can see. In the ending, if you break it down, it is an ice map with two ice slides. So a very short one. Gonna be some quick rounds here. And definitely a map where also good players could quite easily lose a life. Players like Lars. And we only have only Lars, Skandir, and Fredwolf with three lives, by the way. The rest all have lost at least one. So yeah, what a map. Let's see what is going to happen here. We have four players with only one life left. So we could possibly see multiple KOs here. Oh, no. Yeah, hello. My name is Ice. Woo. Honestly, I tested the map. I did like three or four runs. I never slid out. But I'm also ice abuser, as we all saw yesterday in the Cup of the Day. What is happening? Nobody is finishing, and it's purple surviving. And Salmon actually... No, wait, what? Huh? Yeah, purple surviving, and Auris barely dodging the death, and it is Salmon going out. Now, that's kind of funny, because Salmon is actually quite good at ice. But Salmon in 15th, 07 to Salmon. Was nice to have you. Oh, no, I think I put Salmon into my predictions quite high. That's fucked up. Scheiße, ey. Well, GG to Salmon. Holy moly, eh? What a map. So basically, you just need to survive. But we all know with ice, it's difficult. But it shouldn't be too hard. Oh, we have some lags here. Skandir. Okay, Skandir. Oh, Skandir lost a life and he will probably lose another one now. Croxy. Oh, we have respawn. No, everybody's sliding around. I love ice. Woo. And it's actually... No, it's not Croxy out. Plisky's out. What is happening? Skandir with a DNF. Skandir only down to one life. Skandir with the ice issue, yeah. But yeah. Plisky out. Holy moly, F. Next up, we have a map of the category LOL. This was the LOL map that I rolled. We have a lot of shit maps right now. I gotta say that. There's gonna be more normal maps coming up later. But we have a map of the category LOL. And it's basically, yeah, it's a royal map. A royal white map. A royal white LOL. You could say this map is Royal LOL. That was a bad joke. But this map is very bad. I can tell you that much. This is not a great map. There is a small trick you can do. It's basically just two jumps you have to do. Jump one. And then jump two. You can go straight. But you can also go left or right. Which you should do. Because you get a stronger reactor boost. And you can get heavy speed boosts here. You can get a crazy, crazy speed boost. And I think my strat like that I figured out was insta air brake and small release. Is what I figured out. But we're gonna see if people will see that as well. I'm actually gonna go in Chem 7 the first round to show you guys the difference in speed here. Because everybody's gonna arrive here at the same time, but some people will soup like crazy and some others will not. Look at this, soup. Oh, and we have Lars from Germany losing his first life. And in the meantime, Intax sadly out. Intax in 13th place, 07 to Intax. Was nice having you. GG. But yeah, Lars losing a life, and with that, there is only Fredwolf with three lives left. Crazy. Fredwolf, the only one with three lives. The safest player right now, you could say. I shouldn't tell strats, by the way. Lars ain't listening. Yeah, I know. I mean, I don't think... Is anybody listening of the players? I should maybe not tell it. But look, people are not doing it. People are not airbraking at all. They're not going for the speed boost. And what's happening... Skandir out in 12. Ain't no way. Okay, Skandir, really hard. Two very unlucky maps. That is crazy. He lost three lives in four rounds. That is crazy. Anyway, we go over to the next map. And this one is by Schlumpy. It's called RRCS Hello World. Apparently, it's a competition map. I'm actually not sure. What style was this? It's not grass. Is it so? I think it is sausage. Wait, let me actually go into investigation mode real quick. How's it called? Hello World. Investigation mode. I forgot. Scheiße. Hello world. Well, we can find it. Ah, it was grass then. Okay, well then it was actually the grass map that we have. The official grass map of the tournament. And this one is very proper. A proper competitive map. I don't know if, like, it's, apparently it's from a competition. I don't know what competition it's from. But if players played it, then good for them, of course. That can always happen with Dingsbums maps, with random maps. People might know the maps, and if they do, then lucky for them. Okay, first round of the map. Let's see what's gonna happen. Mach Reintje touching in the start, that is not optimal, that's for sure. Blef also with a small touch. But this map is quite difficult. It's really not easy to survive this. And Mach Rein played in this competition? Eh, no way. So Mach Rein might know the map. Doesn't look like it, to be honest. But, yeah, anyway, maybe it's been a long time ago. Who knows? We don't know. Currently we have Auris in last place, overtaking Croxy, and Mach Rein, Croxy and Auris all have only one life left, so they should better gear up a little bit and try to overtake. Otherwise, the mud is literally calling. Auris currently looking strong, Torpor actually quite far in the back. Oh, I think Croxy had a giga long respawn. Yeah, Croxy is fully in the mud. So Auris, wait, what is happening? I'm so confused. Okay, Auris actually is gonna be out. Riposa. We have two knockouts. The first double KO. 07 to Auris and Croxy. Can we get an 014? Because we have double 07. We need a 0014. Well, that's first of all focus. 014. Wait, that's actually an emote? Ain't no way. We actually have 014 as an emote. Okay, I didn't even know that was a thing. 014. That's a banger. Anyway, I tapped out again. Dude, fuck this. Really mad. So, let's see. We have a close fight. Purple fighting against Snappy right now. And Snappy only has one life. Also, Lars struggling a little bit. And Lars also only one life left. No, two lives. But he could drop to one life. And I'm pretty sure he doesn't want that. And Lars now actually almost in last place. We have close fight. Tarpor touching. Snappy touching. So, both of them should be out here probably. Unless something really weird happens. Blef. Wait, Blef fell behind. So Tarpor might actually be safe. Yes, Tarpor is safe. And we have to say bye-bye to Snappy instead. Snappy in 9th, respectable position. 07 Snappy, GG to him. Okay, we go over to the next map. In the meantime, I'm going to show you what players can win today. I didn't even do that yet. Here you can see them. We have a mixture of prize money and goodies this time. First place is going to win 125 euro as well as our current big Trackmania jersey, which is also worth like 70, 80 euro, I think it costs in the shop. So yeah, around 200 euro for first. Second place is going to win 75 euro as well as a Philips One Blade, which you can also see in the background here. A Philips One Blade, a razor basically. And then third place is going to win 50 euro as well as the brand new big mousepad, which is really, really cool. Big mousepad. I have it here. I cannot show you right now, but it's a very cool one. Anyway, we go over to the next map. And we have the map called Smile. And this one is very easy to remember the style on because it is multi-lap. We have a multi-lap map, guys, which is 2 minutes long. It is quite long. I know it's a 2 minute long map. Here we go. 2 minutes multi-lap coming in. And this is honestly kind of a simple map, so it shouldn't be too tricky. We have a little bit of NASCAR here in the beginning. We have a bobsleigh U-turn, as you can see, where you want to carry a lot of speed out of. Then we're also going to have a wood section coming up. And that's pretty much the end of the map already. So, yeah. Interesting map. And I mean, 2 minutes long. That could assure some cool comebacks, because even if you make a mistake in the first 10 seconds, you might be able to come back at the ending. And yeah, here's the first lap done. Oh, and you need to, okay, you want good speed into the second lap, otherwise you need to go for the safe route here, which is not good. So yeah, gonna be interesting. We have three players with one life left. This is also the final map where the bottom two are gonna lose a life. So we don't have many players left actually, only 8 of them. That's crazy. So let's see. Two players are gonna lose one. Let's see what's gonna happen. Keyboard players in the mud? I don't think so. We can watch Elkon on the wood. I don't think he will fail it. I highly doubt Elkon will fail the wood. That's not gonna happen. Like, the wood is keyboard friendly. And you don't need to be, like, extraordinary fast. The start, everybody got pretty good. Blef with good speed here. Mach Rein falling a little bit behind. And with that, Mach Rein actually quite a bit behind the field. That is not too good. But as I said, we have two laps. Oh, Purple. What did Purple must have touched inside. So let's see. Elkon. Look at this. Elkon surviving easily. No problem with keyboard. Elkon in first. No keyboard issue. Oh, very interesting way of Elkon jumping into the things. It might have looked weird, but with this, with the way he jumped into, he avoided getting an acceleration penalty. Very smart here. Ah, yeah, wait, true, my bad. It's not even two laps, it's three laps, actually. My bad. We're playing three laps of this. It's not only two, it's three. My bad. Dick. Okay, Heath lost 10 seconds in lap one. That is not very good. So he needs to catch up big time. Purple is not too far away. But, yeah, in lap 2, it doesn't seem like there are any mistakes, to be honest. Oh, okay, Heath is so out. Heath is outer than out. Like, he is the outest. He is so in the mud. Yeah, Heath, choose Heath. Can already say that. But maybe Purple has a chance, because Bluff is not too far away. And, I mean, there could still be a mistake, of course. Very possible. So, let's see. Oh, Purple with a nice entry. He will have more speed. He is catching up to Bluff, but the ending, there is not a lot happening. But if Bluff has bad speed into the wood, maybe Purple can catch up. That would be crazy. Okay, I think Bluff is safe. GG to Bluff for surviving. Yep, Bluff very safe. And Heath is gonna go out. Purple gonna be in last, but he's gonna go down to one life. So Purple not out yet. It could have, we could get an 014 here. So, yeah. Actually, three people with only one life. That is crazy. So, let's see. Purple was fast on this map, but he crashed the sausage turn twice somehow. So, if he manages to not crash it, he should be safe. But let's see. Start is looking pretty close. And Fredwolf still with three lives. And Fredwolf is cooking this edition, man. Holy shit. Crazy. Fredwolf literally cooking. So, will somebody crash the inside? Nope. Fredwolf going for a huge jump, not losing out on speed a lot. And look at this, we have a fight. Oh, we don't have a I mentioned him once and he's dead. Fredwolf with the respawn and he's gonna lose a lot of seconds with that. Elkon going for this crazy jump in different line than everyone else. And you see he is gaining a lot of time with that. Look at this, it's so much faster. It looks dumb, but it's so good. Crazy. Crazy, crazy, crazy. So, going into lap 2 here. Let's see what's gonna happen. Fredwolf in the mud. And look at this. Lars is fighting. Lars is fighting for his life. He needs a good third lap if he wants to catch someone. Or a crash in the woods. But it doesn't look like it. No crash in the woods. So, Lars needs a good third lap. Otherwise, the favorite and the current champion is gonna go to his final life. Oh, but he's not aware of the line, though. He's getting really bad speed. And now he needs to risk. Oh, Purple not with the greatest bobsleigh. Ah! Come on, Lars. Can he catch up? In the meantime, Bluff and Purple need to stay ahead. Because, Lars with good speed. Lars with good speed. Lars with good speed. Is it enough to catch up? Is it enough? Is it enough? Is it enough? Oh, it's not enough. Good race, though. 2 minutes of driving and players are only 3 seconds apart. That is crazy. And with that, Lars going down to one life only. And Lars, as I said, is the current reigning champion. He won the very first edition and he is trying to do the back-to-back. So that is difficult, eh? Holy moly. And now, this is the map I was waiting for. We have Nathan of the week, I guess. Nathan's parkour. And this is the RPG map. And this one is not easy. Wait, it's by Betonmancher. Yeah, so this is RPG, and this is actually not easy. This is actually difficult. Actually difficult map. You need good lines here. 90 seconds finish timeout. You will need it. Because, as you can see, this is hard. I've managed to finish the map within 1 minute 50 the first try. 1 minute 50. So you need to climb up here, and you need good bobsleigh and good jump for that. The map is not too hard. Like, it is, in my opinion, drivable. I finished it somewhat quickly. So let's see. Oh my god, okay, people are struggling. Wait, can we put the timeout even higher up? Wait, here, John C, can you quick fix? I think we need more finish timeout. People are struggling so much with this. I got this like second or third try. But so many people are still at the start. Hello, John C, type 1. What do you want? I don't know, dude. 10 minutes. I just want people to finish. I mean, it's kind of, the thing is, it kind of sucks if there's going to be more than one player losing a life. Okay, we will increase finish timeout. But yeah, you basically have to do this. You go up the Dingsbum stand. We have the first one finishing. Fredwald finishing. Then you have a plastic bounce here. Plastic bounce into water. Then a pipe with a small pipe flip. And then wetwood. Like, the start is the hardest part. Start is the hardest part. So let's see. Yeah, many people are not gonna make it. Okay, 3 people made it. 3 out of 7. Not too bad, I guess. Oh my god, this is crazy. Okay, let's first of all see who's gonna win. Let's see who's gonna win. So Elkhorn survived. Elkhorn going for the bounce. Ping. Not making it. Tarpor made it. Tarpor now in first. Tarpor, of course, a little bit of an RPG player. So this is a crazy map. I was really thinking, is this one okay to put in or not? And I was like, ah, fuck it. So yeah, this here, this is all not too hard. It's basically only the start. The start is the hardest part. So Tarpor actually doing everything first try, it looks like. Risky finish, also super easy. And there we go. Oh, look at this. Okay, okay, okay. It's actually 10 minutes. Chauncey actually put 10 minute finish timeout. It's actually 10 minute finish timeout. Jeepers. Okay, oh, we have a fight. Look at this. Mareintje fighting versus Fredwolf. But is it going to be Mareintje? Yes. Oh my god. No, wait. Bleff is out. Wait, Bleff fell behind. Okay. Actually, everybody within 20 seconds. Holy moly. Not that. Okay, okay. Like, the warm-up looked very chaotic, but it was fine in the ending. By 07 to Bleff. For being 7th, Bleff is out. But this is a crazy map. This one, when you have pressure and money's on the line, this is crazy. And I mean, now we have 6 players left, and half of them is going to win something. So you don't want to be in the other half. So let's see. Once again, the start is the hardest part. You want a good bob. Mareintje is definitely going to get it, unless he fucks it up. No, he easily gets it. Crazy good job by him. Is someone not getting it? Oh my god, Lars! Lars, as an RPG player, the only one not getting it on the RPG map. Okay, that's crazy.
There's a chance. Come on, please. Yes. Okay. Wait, don't tell me. Everybody made it! What do you mean?
That is crazy. Okay, but people could get stuck here. Where's Lars? Lars is here. It's okay, okay, Lars has a chance, Lars has a chance. Lars, he needs to cook now, he needs to cook. But Lars is getting cooked. But Tarpor is also getting cooked. Tarpor surviving, where's Lars? Lars also surviving. Okay, we have a fight, we have a fight. Lars needs to risk, where's Marijn? Marijn, he didn't make it, Lars is safe. Okay, Lars needs to survive though. What a fight though. Lars saving his ass on this map. If he doesn't die, he needs to make it now, he needs to not crash. Plastic bounce, he's surviving and it should be enough. Oh my god, Lars. Lars saving his German ass here. Holy moly, what a fight. Okay, that was crazy. Holy shit, Lars. That is freaking crazy. Mareintje out though. 07 Mareintje. 6th place, I think, for Mareintje. Very, very solid. GG to Marijn. So, next up, we have a map called Thanks for the New Tech XD Sceneryless. And this is a Bugslide map. Yeah, hello. We have a Bugslide map. I wrote Bugslide as one of the styles. And this is one of the maps. It's a rather easy Bugslide map, and also a rather bad Bugslide map, to be honest. So it's gonna be interesting. Let's see what's gonna happen here. We have a wet tire Bugslide here, which is super, super weird, to be honest. But as you can see, it works somewhat, I guess. And then we have a small snow car section, with which you have to set up into the stadium car Bugslide. And also a speed check. So the ending could cook the one or other... Why? Elkhorn? Elkhorn, hello? Elkhorn type 1? Can we pause the round, John C, real quick? Is that possible? Can we pause? Can we pause it? Can we pause it? Or is that resetting everything? That would be bad. Not that I know of. Scheiße. Elkhorn, what happened? Okay, that's fucked up. UDP initialization failed. I cannot reconnect. Huh? I don't know how we pause. I don't know how it works. The thing is, we're also running a custom script. I don't know if it's possible to pause. Give pro money. Man, Elkhorn out. That's actually sad, eh. That is sad. Anyway, nothing we can do now. And TM2 the same. Okay. Yeah, anyway, next map is called the 8th Road by Ryu Nohai. And this one was part of the category Freestyle. This is the Freestyle map. And if I can give players one tip, there is a huge speed check in the ending. And if you have to respawn and you don't have the speed, your only chance is to go all the way back and gather speed again for the jump. So the ending is tricky. The ending is tricky. Okay, but for the next month, that's actually some good feedback, like Bö, who coded this game mode for us. Maybe I can ask him, or maybe he can, if it doesn't exist yet, he can program in a way to pause the plugin. But that's nothing we were aware of. I also, like, usually people don't just, like, you know, disconnect. That usually doesn't happen. So it's very shit for Elcon. I'm super sorry for that. But it was nothing we could have done now. Anyway, let's see if people are gonna make the speed check in the ending or not. The rest of the map is very simple and very bad, to be honest. Like, there is nothing really happening here. It's just like regular driving on roads. It looks like someone's first map. And yeah, here is where you need speed. You don't need that much speed, but you need speed. Like, you can easily overjump this, but yeah, it's also very easy to not have enough speed, basically. Four players left: Lars, Purple, Fredwolf, and Tarpor. And one of them is gonna go home without any prizes. So let's see what's gonna happen here. Will we see Lars or Purple being knocked out, or will we not in this round? Let's see. After this, we only have two maps left, by the way. So the tournament is coming closer to an ending. And did we have the first mistake here by Fredwolf? Not really a mistake, but a small slow section. Oh, small touch by Tarpor, but actually not bad, because you want to reduce airtime either way. So very close race still. Fredwolf still a little bit behind. Song skip? Yeah, I can skip. Okay, we have very awkward drift here. And also for this turn, you need quite some speed. And everybody is gonna get it. And we have a close race. The map is shit, but the race is good. The map is shit, but the race is good. Educational is still coming? No, Educational is not coming. We still have Sausage left. And Sausage and something else. I don't remember. Okay, still a close race, eh? It looks like Fredwolf might go out, but this turn here is tricky. Oh, Fredwolf! Okay, Fredwolf is gonna lose his life here. I think Fredwolf is gonna lose his life. And with that, Tarpor will actually be the best man in the field, but Purple with low speed. But it should be fine. Unless he doesn't have enough speed for the finish. It's fine, it's fine, it's fine. Yes, it's fine. Dude, close race. 1:20 long map. Everybody within a second. That is crazy. Anyway. Focusing on the rest of the tournament. Let's see what's gonna happen here. Ooh, close race nonetheless. Lars. Oh my god. The thing is, if it would be, honestly, for the cinema, Tarpor needs to get last. Tarpor needs to lose this round for the cinema, because then everybody has only one life. Come on. I want cinema, and I know you guys want as well. Cinema, cinema, cinema. In the meantime, shout out to Wolvik for sponsoring this tournament. Hashtag it. So, will we... Nein! No cinema. Purple out. Purple out. Cinema has not been achieved. GG to Purple. And Purple is the final player who is not gonna win something. No. Feels bad, man, for Purple. But Purple did really, really good, to be honest. Purple, really good performance. 0-7 to Purple. Fourth place. Very, very respectable. Going over to the next... Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh no, this is bad. This is very bad, guys. This is the reactor map, guys. This is the map of the style reactor, and this one is giga dog shit. This is giga dog shit, I can tell you that much. Why is this the second last map? Oh no, this is so bad. This is such a bad map. This is such a bad map. Look at this. Look at this. It's bobsleigh, it's reactor, it's way too fast. It is just fucking bad. Look at this point. Wait! No way, Tarpor! Holy shit! Dude, that was insane. What the fuck? We even have an anti-boost here for no freaking reason. This map is horrible. I am so sorry that this is coming up now in the, yeah, almost most exciting spot. I am deeply sorry. This is terrible. Oh, hell nah, man. Hell nah. Hell nah. Wait, technically... Wait, is this the last map? Yeah, this is. Wait, this is. No, is it the last. Wait. Wait, this is. No, we. Wait, we could even finish on this map, actually. Right? We could finish on this map. Yeah, if Tarpor could finish on this map already. Could be the last one. We technically have one map left, but it could be the last one. But now I'm confused. Was there one round where one more player than intended lost a life? Because this is weird, to be honest. Like, we should have... Something went wrong with the knockouts. Probably on the golf map? Yeah, maybe. But... Yeah, anyway, technically we should definitely go on to the next map, but let's see. As long as Tarpor doesn't win both rounds... Oh, actually, Tarpor looking really good. Oh, Fred... Ah, no, Fred... Nee, Tar... Yeah, nee, nee, nee. Yeah, Tarpor needs to lose a life here. Oh my god, Lars has low speed. Anti-boost. No reason for it. What a yak map. Tarpor... Dude, Tarpor is cooking, eh? Holy shit. Tarpor is really good, man. Crazy. Where's the finish on this map? I forgot. Is there still anything happening? Oh, can you fuck up here still? That's the question. Is it possible to fuck up? I'm not sure where the finish is.
Just bob. No way! No way! Dude, oh come on, there's no way, I almost got them!
Oh, you can fuck up still. Oh! 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 Tarpor! Oh my god! No freaking way, good race, eh? Holy shit! Boah, that was sick! Dude, holy moly, Lars out! That was crazy, Tarpor almost fucked it up! Holy shit, GG Lars though. GG not, Lars being not being able to defend his title. Third place though. Dude, what a crazy map though. Will it be decided here? Fred Wolf needs to win this round. He has to win it. He has to win it. And I know what map is coming up after. And I think on the map coming up next, Fred Wolf has a better chance, to be honest. Because I know it's a rather normal map. I know which one is missing. It's the sausage map. And that one is rather normal. So Fred Wolf needs... Where is Fred Wolf going? Oh, 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 cinema! Ladies and gentlemen, cinema! Tarpor losing 110 seconds in one turn. Ach du Scheiße. Tarpor is deep in the mud. Okay, Fred Wolf, listen. You have 10 seconds, Fred Wolf. Listen up, my friend. You just need to survive. You just need to survive, Fred Wolf. Yeah, hello? Salatman with a 69 euro donation? Out of nowhere? What the fuck? Prize money for Elcon. Should I really send 69 euro to Elcon now? Honestly, that would be a bit too much because he's getting more than third place. Yes. Pocketed. Like, Elcon would get more than third place. The thing is though, I cannot send him 69 euro because I have to pay taxes on it. I would literally make minus then. Can we agree on 50 euro? Can we agree on 50 euro? 49.50? Because I have to pay taxes on donations, guys. So it would be kind of fucked up for me. Okay, guys, we're gonna do a gamba later. We're gonna do a prediction later. Or not prediction, but like a vote. A poll on what we should do. Anyway, we go over onto the last map. It's Haim Jima, built by Xcoolio. And the style of this map is sausage. And this is... a very normal map, actually. A very normal driving style map. So, let's see who is going to be the better player. We're only going to have one round here. One round deciding it all. Who's going to win it? We will see. Warm-up is looking very shaky from both players. Fred Wolf a little bit ahead. And Fred Wolf, I guess, is trying to finish the map very quickly. So that Tarpor might not see the entire map. So, let's see. We have a risky... Oh my god, we have a risky finish as well. Tarpor is making it. Okay, good luck. One round, which is going to decide everything today. After the tournament is done, I have one announcement to make. Not a new announcement, but something regarding the edition of next month, which is very important. So after this is over, make sure to quickly stay here, please. Very important. But now, let's focus on the final round. Tarpor versus Fred Wolf. Who is going to be the one winning? It is a rather normal driving map, and... And arguably, Fredwolf is better at normal driving. But it's not decided yet. Wait a second, it's not decided yet. He only has 2 seconds. There is a risky finish. It is not set in stone, but Tarpor...
He turtled, GG.
Yeah.
Let's
go. Full speed finals.
Bro, get the Gillette. He gets the Gillette fucking razor. Holy.
Dude, I don't even have any beard.
GG to Fredwolf for winning the Big Kick Monthly Cup edition September 2024. Yeah. That was, a bit of an anticlimactic final, to be honest. He could have still made it though. If Fredwolf fucks up the risky. But he can literally go safe. Oh, he's going dirty safe. But it's Fredwolf winning the edition. A bit of a yak final, not gonna lie. But nonetheless, second place for Tarpor. Big GG to him. Honestly, way better than I would have expected him. Second place is really, really good by Tarpor. So GG to Tarpor, 07 to him. And GG to Fredwolf for winning the edition September 2024. GG, I hope you all enjoyed. Thank you very much for joining. It was very fun again. The Big Kick Monthly Cup is, of course, going to continue next month as well. And there is something important for next month. So quickly wait here, guys. Quickly wait. One very important thing, guys. Everybody listen up, please. Because next month, and already next Monday, the Big Kick Monthly Cup is going to go into its next edition, of course. Edition October 2024. So we're once again going to have 3 weekly qualifiers. All of you guys can join. And overall, the top 20 will then qualify to the monthly final. However, very important. Next month is not going to use random maps as we did this month. But instead, next month, we will be using maps built by you guys. So all of you guys can build maps and submit them for the Big Yak Monthly Cup. Very, 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 very important. If you are interested in that, you can check my Discord. Make sure to join. And then check out the Big Yak Monthly Cup category and the news channel. Here you can see all of the requirements for the maps, for example, the length, difficulty, etc. And also the link to the map pack, which you have to upload the map to. So all of you guys can send in maps, build something cool, wicked, something super stupid. Can be almost anything you want. Just have to follow these criteria and then upload your map. There is still 1 week left to send in maps. So there is still a little bit of time. So make sure to send in your maps if you're interested. I can check real quick how many maps we have. 45 maps, but we at least need 60 overall, so we still need more maps, guys. Send in your maps. Give him 30 euro Trostpreis, 40 or 50 euro, and rest to the prize pool of next month. Yeah, then we could also do a bit of, like, we could add a little bit of that money to the prize pool of next month, to the winner, maybe. A little bit of money to the winner and a bit of money to Elkon. What do we think about that? 25, and that should also be fine with taxes. Discussion over. We are done for today, ladies and gentlemen. I really hope you enjoyed this month's Big Yak Monthly Cup. Once again, a reminder that you guys can send in your maps for the next month of the Big Yak Monthly Cup. Make sure to do so if you're interested. Join my Discord. There you can find all of the information that you need. And put the entire 50 on next month's first place so I can get it all. Should I do it, Elkon? Should we do it? If you say so, Elkon, I can do it. that would be Giga Chat, to be honest. Yes, okay, Elkon decided it. We're gonna put the 50 euro into the prize pool for next month. Giga Chat, dude, if Elkon wins next month, that would be story of the century.